We're up and running now, are we? Let me see here. Oh yeah, we're up and running. Hi there, everybody.
Hi.
It's the ramble, and this is the TV side of it. If you're just looking at us, and let me see here. Where is where do I turn this thing on? See, I'm getting to the point where I'm forgetting simple processes. See, that's why I want to kill myself.
Listen, I have to go before you.
And plus, you know, I got a loose tooth and I'm fat.
Stop
and,
it. Here we go again.
And I'm fat.
Enough.
We put
enough.
The picture up there on the Facebook page.
Well, you put the picture up.
I did. Yeah, that's what I look like, folks.
That's what he did look like.
And that's what I look like.
It's going away.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You think so, huh? You know, the phone lines are open, by the way, in case you felt like calling. And the number here is, you use Skype, and it's...
You're asking me?
Gabnet Live. Gabnet Live is the ID you use. Also, let me mention there's a phone number as well. These are all at gabnet.net. So, you know, if you forget any of this, just go over there. 347-352-0079. That's 347-352-0079. Well, the lines have been open for a little bit. We should be getting our first call any moment, but we're not.
It's only 10:30.
What?
It's only 10:30.
Well, it's 10:31. You know, usually by this time, we've at least heard from our good friend Phil Meyer, or heard from Scott Boddicker, or somebody like that, you know. We're waiting. Wait a minute. Somebody is ringing. Oh,
yay!
There he is.
Here we go.
It's over on that screen. I forgot. Oh, hey.
Here comes
Scott Boddicker. Here comes Scott Boddicker.
Isn't that Phil?
Yeah, there's Phil there.
Hey,
yeah,
Phil. Yeah, hey, Scott.
Let me put the screen on here. We'll do this little. This is a sexy thing I do where I have, kind of, I'm here and then they're over there.
I'm all the way behind the computers because I'm not allowed to be seen.
Yeah, that's true. Wait a minute. Let me see if they can get them to see you. There. Wait a minute.
No, it's okay. Just leave it.
There we go. There you are. Wave your hand. Wave. See? Wave. Okay. That's so everybody can see a girlfriend. Hello, guys. How are you this evening?
Hi, guys.
What's happening?
Hey, evening.
What's happening?
I got flag. I can't see you, Alex. You got him, Phil?
Wait a minute. Am I?
I got him.
You got him? I might have to reboot.
No, don't worry about it. I may come in.
I'd like to see you.
But you will see me. Just hold on to your horses.
He's wearing green. Must be St. Patty's Day.
No, I'm not wearing green. This isn't green. This is gray.
That's gray?
That's gray.
Uh-oh.
Look at that. That's gray.
Fix your color.
Huh?
I've got a calibrated monitor.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Every monitor's calibrated.
No, I have a color monkey.
You have a color monkey? Speaking of monkeys, here's Tony.
Maybe they'll bring you in for me.
Yeah. Yeah. Let me see here.
It's Tony.
Yeah. You see Tony? Yeah. Okay,
yeah.
Scott. But you can't see me, right? You don't want to see me anyway.
Well, at least now I don't have to look at Phil.
Alex,
all the time.
You don't have the camera facing you. That's why you can't see.
What do you mean
see?
I don't have the camera facing
me? It's like it's in this direction.
No, it's facing me. I can see here what I've got. Oh. Picture I've got.
Oh.
Oh, God. Everybody tells me what to do.
Tell me what to do. Everybody tells me what to do.
Well, anyway, let's see. I bet we. Hopefully we'll get a lot of callers tonight.
I'll give a shout out to my friend.
What friend?
Monique, who was trying to get on to hear you last week, but missed the shout out.
Did she get the show?
I think she got the show. Call me tomorrow.
By the way, what I have here, see this? What? What?
Oh, he's got his box.
That's a color spectrometer. It's called a color monkey.
Yeah.
And it's what you use to calibrate your screen and your printer.
Well, this is gray, so go buy a new chroma monkey or whatever that is.
maybe I need to calibrate it.
Wait a minute. Scott Boddicker has enabled video. Now maybe that's it. Can you see me now?
Not quite.
What do you mean not quite?
It's like half print.
Well, I thought I saw it swirling, but I don't see that
either. That's swirling. That's a soda.
No, but anyway, look at that. See that? That's
pure. That looks like Coke.
Pure, no. It's pure gold. Pure gold. Tell me how much it is a bottle.
$2.49.
Oh, my God.
What is it?
Stewart's Diet Root Beer. Man, it is the best.
It is good.
It is really good. And she's gone nuts for it.
I get two cases at a quip.
She sends away for two cases at a time.
And they're coming from Chicago and no shipping charge.
Oh.
You know.
Amazon.
What?
Amazon?
No.
Beverage.com. Beverage Direct.
Beverage Direct. And they said
shipping charge because it's $2.49 a bottle for, 8 ounces?
Well, I mean, that's about what you'd pay for it in a store.
Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's always been the there was a time when it was 25 cents.
Well, yeah.
You know, but, I mean, times have changed. And now,
movies were 15 cents.
Yeah, huh? Hoover was in office.
Hoover was in office. Thank you very much.
Not during my time.
No, I have not. I'm nowhere near having been around for President Hoover.
For one reason or another, there was an email I got, and it was from Ancestry.com.
Uh-huh.
So they said, you know, put in your father's name, your birthday, your name.
You don't know why you got something from Ancestry.com? Because you're the last person in America to get something from Ancestry.com.
Yeah, really.
And you can go back a certain distance for free.
All of a sudden, I was able to see my grandfather's 1930 census.
Yeah, and I saw my grandparents, too.
It was very interesting.
Well, you know what's also very interesting to go to is to go to the Ellis Island site.
Wow, that had an impact.
And you can. I found my grandmother's name with my father's name there when they came in through Ellis Island.
Yeah.
And my grandfather, we just lost Scott. I don't know why. He probably decided to go away.
Might be rebooting.
Huh?
He might be rebooting. He probably wants your picture.
Well, you don't have a show here, folks. People got to start calling, you know.
So what I didn't really realize that my grandmother was born in England and my grandfather was born in Russia, but I think she was from Russia and just born in England on the way over.
Yeah. Yeah, but she was Jewish, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was Jewish. In those days, Jews always married Jews.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it said that he paid $55 a month rent.
Really?
Yeah, in Queens. And in 1930, he was in Queens, and I think they moved to Brooklyn.
Really?
No. I remember what happened. They died, and my father ended up living with his aunt and living in Brooklyn. That's how it happened.
Why are we? Oh, I see. Okay. These things don't happen immediately. There we go. I see. Okay. I'm just looking. I was looking at the delayed picture on the... got a lot more people than we've ever had watching the TV thing right now. And there's just two of us.
Yeah.
What?
Isn't there a lawsuit against... what's his face from being born in Canada?
I think there is.
Yeah.
There actually is. Yeah. Yeah.
His reasoning is that since his mother was an American, that makes him a natural born American. But I don't think that's the way it works.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Well, they want them to clarify that. You know, how does it work?
I know that with McCain, he was born on a U.S.
He was born to American parents on an American territory, or you know,
an army base, and that counts.
Yeah. And that's okay. What?
Your Cruz was not. You know, he was born to an American mother, with a Cuban father, but in Canada.
By the way, I hello there, Rob.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Rob.
There he is.
Hey, Marjorie, how are you?
Hey, Rob, get in the middle of your picture. You're kind of off. It looks like at half your face.
It's weird. It's like split screen.
Look at that.
Where?
Oh, yeah. How did that happen?
I don't know.
Let me is that turn a mirror?
The camera. Turn the camera off and then turn it back on again. This is fun. Yeah. That's strange.
There we go.
We hope so. I haven't seen you yet.
I see it that way.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm not getting you.
Camera.
There you go. There you go.
All right.
Okay.
I was half a man there for a bit.
What was causing?
Lost a lot of weight in that shot.
Well, at least people can see that happening, you know, on the show tonight. Anyway, our number is Gabnet Live. If you're using Skype, and if you're not using Skype, then you can use the phone number, which is. Can anybody remember the phone number?
347-352-0079.
Well, say that again.
347-352-0079.
I can't remember phone numbers. Do you know that when I was doing radio, when I was doing the program at Sirius, I had to look at the phone every time I said the phone number.
Do you recognize PL91000?
PL91000 was, I believe, WMCA.
That's right.
I didn't remember that.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, when I was a kid and you had to dial phones.
Yeah, you knew, you remembered all the numbers.
Yeah, I remembered all the numbers. But, it's, you know, now that you have these smartphones, it's made me dumb.
Yeah.
You know, I don't remember anything.
I don't either. So,
you know, if I lost the phone, I'd be up Shit Creek.
Wow. Yeah.
No. Hey, so last night I mentioned to you guys that my wife and I are going to get a private tour of the Capitol.
Yeah.
Wow. I worked in the Capitol.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I worked for the Senate.
Cool.
Wow.
Yeah. And there's a train that goes from the Capitol to the main part of the Capitol, like an underground subway where they take when they're going for votes and they're in a hurry.
Yeah.
It's kind of neat. Yeah. I worked for the Senate.
That's where they gas you?
Yeah, I was on the Senate side.
Who did you work for at the Senate?
Oh, God, the worst. Arlen Specter.
Wow, Arlen Specter.
Philadelphia? Yeah. Pennsylvania?
Yeah.
He was Republican.
Well, he started out as a Democrat, then he went to Republican.
Yeah.
He got older.
He was terrible.
Scotty, you there?
Yes.
Yeah, we can't see your picture.
Well, I can see everybody now. That's funny. Now you can't see me. Let me spike all it again here.
Didn't he have something to do with the Spectrum Theater in Philadelphia?
Yeah, there you go.
That's a sporting theater, basketball. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know if he had anything to do with it. I don't know.
Or it's family, no.
I don't think so. But
I don't even know if it's spelled the same way.
So,
I have something for show and tell I want to show you. My wife brought this home for me today.
Show me, because I'm going to sleep soon. Let me see.
She's gotten very close to this family that, you know, the former congressman.
Yeah.
And she gave him these for me.
What are they? Wait a minute. They're a little
cufflinks.
Blurry. They're cufflinks.
Those are congressional cufflinks.
They were.
Wow. Oh, I'll show you something that's even better.
Her husband's.
Hold on.
Wait a minute. What are you going to get? What is it? This is really show and tell tonight.
Yeah. I was shocked.
Cool. Those are congressional cufflinks. Oh, what is this?
This is, I think, $100,000.
Can you use one of them as a lapel pin?
This is $100,000.
Maybe $10,000.
Let's see here. It's Federal Reserve Bank of New York.
I could.
Cash function. Shredded U.S. currency. Briquette. Facts, and then it says, it's approximately
$1,000. Oh, $1,000.
Wait a minute.
I thought it was
$1,000. Number of notes, approximately 1,000. Oh, but what kind of notes are they? That's the question. But it's.
There it is.
Mm-hmm. It's a brick of money.
From the Federal Reserve.
Very nice. Yeah, that's what our money will be worth, shredded.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, so you got the cufflinks. That's nice. Yeah. Wow.
They love
now he's going to try and sneak into the congressional elevator where one of them is a pin.
Well, yeah.
You know, well, you see, so far, we've had it for show and tell. We've had a
spectrometer.
Huh?
My spectrometer.
Your spectrometer. We've had Rob Alfano's cufflinks.
I got a softball here if anyone cares.
Got a softball? Okay.
Shredded money from the Federal Reserve.
Yeah, shredded money from the Federal Reserve from us. Tony, do you have anything to show us?
Nothing special. I got a great accomplishment.
Join the club.
Hold on, what do I tell you?
You know, next week I'm going to try and rig this thing with two cameras over on the
PC. I got an extra Manowar for sale on Comic-Con.
Because the
soon.
Picture, is, put it up yet, the picture is so much better on the PC. It's like high def.
It?
And you people, you're on your old computer.
Yeah, I'm on the old computer tonight, and it's the night we do television. But the last time I went to do the television, I did Skype, and then I went to do the television, and it said you can't do Skype with video at the same time that you're doing something else with that camera. So I got to hook the second camera in here somehow and run one thing with that camera, and it's a mess.
You need a product called I don't have it installed in here anymore. But I used to use this product that would split my camera. Because that's typical of a lot of applications. You can't split the camera. There's an application called ScamSplit. I can't remember what the hell it was. This way you can use your camera in multiple applications.
Really?
Yeah. There is an application out there that will do that.
Okay.
Okay. Well, listen, guys, before you start a different topic, I'm signing off.
She's signing off. Yeah, she's going.
Good night, Marjorie.
She's through. Mm-hmm. Okay.
See ya.
Good night. I'll try and lose some weight while I'm on the show. Anybody see the picture I posted?
Yeah, very nice. You trying out for the Olympics?
No, I'm trying out to be the Michelin Man. Yeah. That picture should make anybody who
wants weight.
No, who has weight feel better about themselves.
Yeah. Well, you know, a picture like that only proves one thing. You were definitely fit for the radio business.
Actually, that was a couple of years ago that picture was taken. Yeah. And I lost, I think, some weight since that point, but just by natural
attrition. You look much thinner now.
By natural attrition, but now I'm actually losing weight. Mm-hmm. And what I want to do, I have this thing I want to do. I want to absolutely become emaciated. Kind of like Penn Jillette looks now after losing 100 pounds. You know, I want to look like I'm dying, right? And then I want to get some really just scruffy clothes and then go down to 50th Street subway station, which is right under where Sirius is, and just sit there on the bench sleeping all day. And hope that some people...
I used to be famous.
And hope that some people...
In a cup.
Some people... who have seen me, who see me there, well, then go back to Sirius and go, you won't believe what's happened to Alex Bennett.
He's dying.
He looks good.
He dresses better, you know. Yeah. What?
No wonder you had IBS.
Yeah. You know, Mitt Romney's been on TV. He's been around TV today like a cheap suit, I think.
I watched him before on Bloomberg.
Yeah, to do damage control, I think.
Did you see him? You know, I was just watching. They were saying that anything that this guy does or anybody does seems to entrench Trump even more. And buoy his support.
Yeah.
You know, it's amazing.
Because it just reeks of desperation.
Yeah.
That's why.
And now Bloomberg, they're trying to bring Bloomberg over to the party as a Republican, you know.
Bring Bloomberg over. To what? Yeah. To the Republican Party?
Yeah, that's what I read on Drudge.
Yeah. How much damage did... I mean, Mitt Romney did damage to his brand just by running for president, but how much more damage did he do to his brand by doing this thing against Trump?
I don't think it hurt Romney as much as it helped Trump.
Okay, I'll go along with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll go along with that. But, you know, I wanted to put a thing like up on my Facebook page, but he'd never see it, that would say, Mitt, just shut up and go home. You know, leave us alone. We didn't vote for you. We didn't want you.
I voted for him.
Just go away and leave us alone. Yeah.
Yeah.
Why did you vote for Mitt Romney? Why? Oh, because you couldn't vote.
I like them, actually.
By the way, Obama has a 51% approval rating today.
Saw that.
Yeah. It's going up.
Yeah. Well, you know, he's.
I guess because they look at Cruz and they look at Rubio and they look at Hillary and they look at Trump and they go, you know, maybe Obama wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
You know? Exactly.
You appreciate your girlfriend more when she leaves you, you know. But anyway, so. But I just, you know, just Romney, go home. Leave us alone. We don't, you know, we don't care what you think anymore. We didn't care what you...
Oh, I was going to ask you?
What?
I was trying to tell this to Phil, but it's hard to say it in a message. This on one day.
Oh, you mean in 20 messages?
I know, because I should make it one big one. I'm sorry about that. I'm a nuisance. That
don't matter.
You sent, wait, but wait, before you go any further, you sent me a picture today on Facebook.
I did
send of a chair.
No, the dog's chair.
Of a chair, and then writing me, "This is the only photograph I'm going to send."
Yeah, I didn't want to.
Don't even send me one, okay? Because what do I need with a picture of a chair?
She was looking so cute. I wanted to send.
Oh, the dog was in the chair. I didn't even blow it up to look at it.
She's right there, staring at the camera, my phone. I was leaving for work because I got to take a picture of this. This is a cutie.
Yeah, yeah. Because every dog picture is wonderful and cute, and we all should see it.
I put it on my Facebook page, actually, too.
I love it when people say, look at the expression on his face. And you go, I got news for you. Dogs don't have expressions on their face.
Oh, you don't think they understand?
Yes, they
do. I didn't say they didn't understand. I said they don't have expressions on their faces.
I thought she was sad I was leaving, like, because she was kind of like looking. I said, I got to go.
You know that that spot that plays right after Christmas every year with the animals and the, you know, where they was it the Sarah McLachlan song, and everything is so sad, and you see all the puppy dogs and the kitty cats and
save the animals thing.
Yeah, whatever it is, it's about abuse of animals. And every time I see that commercial, I think, if you played like some sort of a happy song, the animals would look happy. I think it's the music. It's because the animals' faces don't change.
Animals do not have expressions. I don't care what anybody wants to say. Oh, look, the cat's sad.
That's a ripoff on the starving children commercial in Haiti and stuff like that.
You take any kid, take their ice cream cone away from them, and then take a picture of them, and they're going to be perfect for that.
Right.
That's right.
You know?
And you can adopt one of the kids for $30 a month.
Yeah.
What they'll do is they'll send you a picture, but it's the same picture they send everybody.
Yeah, little doe-eyed kids. Yeah,
yeah.
You can feed a hungry child, or you can turn the page. Hello, Patrick.
Hola.
Hola. We can't see you yet. Oh, there you are. There's his lovely little face. There he is. Our poster child for Gabnet, right there.
Yeah.
Our hood ornament for Gabnet.
Right.
Our cherry on top of the sundae for Gabnet. Anyway, how you doing tonight, Patrick?
Oh, all right. I'm enjoying the fucking snow.
what I didn't ask you the other night was, what did you think of Megan?
Well, I thought she was fine.
As I know, you've had a perpetual boner for.
The thing that disappointed me with her outfit is I liked the zipper, but it was too bad she had something on underneath. It would have just been nice to see cleavage. So,
you know, I was also going to mention that Patrick is, except for the Trump thing, the voice of reason on Gabnet.
He is. Oh, yeah, there's no question about it. For a Republican, he's very, very reasonable. That's what I've always liked about Patrick, even back to the days of Sirius. Remember, I used to love having you call the show because he always had a reasonable attitude about his Republicanness, unlike yourself.
No, except for this Trump thing, he's right on.
Well, I think he's right on probably about Trump in most of the way. I mean, you sent me a wonderful picture, Patrick, in which explain it. It's a kid playing with a wall socket, right? There are two receptacles, right?
Yep.
And what was a butter knife? And what was it titled? Let me see here. What was it titled?
The kid was in front of the wall socket with a metal knife.
Yeah.
And said.
Yeah.
Like the top socket was Trump, and the bottom was Hillary. And it says
Trump or Hillary.
Which one do I pick?
Yeah, well, it says top socket or bottom socket.
Yep.
And you know something? That sums it up. That really sums it up. But well, the only problem is
Tony sends you his dog, and you're pissed. He sends you a kid pushing a knife into a socket, and you love it.
Well, because it's funny.
I'm very judicious on what I send, Alex.
He'll take cheat over funny.
And the reason I did is it reminded me of him with his choices because he doesn't like Hillary and he doesn't like Trump to vote for. So if those were the two that were in the election, that would be what he'd be left with. Do I want to vote for Hillary or do I want to vote for Trump? And that would be Alex, and it wouldn't be me.
And your friend Tom said something the other night about Lyndon LaRouche. Maybe he'll run again.
You know, here's the thing.
He always run?
Here's the thing. No, I don't think he's running anymore. Here's the thing. 93. Here's the thing. Somebody, I think it was, who was it the other night when we signed, came close to signing off, and I couldn't figure out, did I want Trump or did I want Hillary? There's nobody to vote for. I'm not going to vote at all. And then they said, yeah, but the Supreme Court's at stake.
Right.
Okay.
Renee.
And that made me take a second look at this thing. You know,
don't you think Trump would appoint better Supreme Court nominees than Hillary?
Here's a question. What kind of person do you think Trump would appoint?
The same as Hillary.
Yeah.
You think so?
That's what he thinks.
They're both Democrats. And I said that one of the reasons I've never liked Trump is he's a Democrat.
So then
anybody says, he never changed his stances. And this change that, you know, everybody can change their mind, yes, but he did not have that history of being a conservative for any length of time to give him any credibility. Like you had said about Reagan, Reagan put distance between himself and political office. And then before he ran as a Republican for president, he put a lot of distance and a lot of speeches and a lot of effort into changing from a Democrat to a Republican. And this has not happened with Trump. And nobody's going to tell me Trump is a Republican.
Okay, but here's the thing.
Reagan was also a governor.
Well, here's the thing, though. Here's the thing. To begin with, Trump is a New Yorker. And being a New Yorker, you're going to have a liberal streak in you anyway. It's just the nature of the town. You lived here, right, Robert? You've dealt with New York.
Sure.
Everybody here is a liberal.
Is he from Brooklyn?
Trump?
Queens,
no,
right?
No, Queens.
Okay.
In fact, right down the street from where Shecky lives.
When my father grew up in Brooklyn, the tough guys used to charge a nickel to get across the street. So my father said he got together with his friends, got 6-inch pieces of rubber hose, and charged the tough guys 10 cents to get back. That's the way people think in New York. If somebody hits you in the shoulder, you hit them back
twice as
hard.
But here's the thing. Here's the thing.
Don't get them back.
I think Trump's a Republican because Trump decided to be a Republican. Oh, wait a minute. Let me finish my thinking here. But he is a liberal Republican. Now, there have been other liberal Republicans. I mean, John McCain was a liberal Republican.
Rockefeller,
liberal Republican, yes.
Nelson, right.
Yeah, and there's nothing wrong with that. Nobody, you know, I hated it when I heard Ted Cruz say, or Rubio say, he's not a Republican, he's not conservative. Well, nobody said you had to be conservative to be a Republican.
That's right.
Oh.
Would you agree or disagree with that, Patrick?
I disagree with it 100%.
Why?
Because I think at this juncture, in order to combat what we're looking at with the Democrat, we've got a very progressive Hillary and then a socialist who's proud of, years ago, there's no Democrat that would have come out as a socialist and said, I'm a socialist. This guy is proud.
Wasn't Lyndon LaRouche a socialist?
And Eugene Debs.
Eugene Debs. There were a lot of them, but they weren't Democrats, I don't think.
Yeah, Debs was a Democrat.
Was he a Democrat or did he run some
union,
kind of...
A union organizer like Sanders. Well, I guess he was pro-union. I don't know if he's an organizer.
Right. You said something that I kind of had to agree with. It by today's standards, yes, they have to be conservative. But the fact is that you can be. What do you do if you're a conservative fiscally, and you're socially a liberal? I mean, where do you go for that? You know, the Democrats are going to.
I think there's room in the party for everybody. For instance, I have nothing against abortion. And I am pro-abortion in one way, anti-abortion in another. Myself, I wouldn't want to abort the baby. But on the other hand, I'm very libertarian in a way where I say, if that's what you want, go ahead and do it. So I think that there's a group that's almost libertarian that don't smoke pot. And those are, you know, liberals, conservatives like me.
Yes, Patrick.
One thing that I did want to correct you on with Trump is he supports Planned Parenthood but does want to defund it.
No, he wants to defund.
He wants to defund the abortion part of it.
Right, but you know what? Planned Parenthood is going to do abortions, and therefore that stance that he's taking, it's kind of a wishy-washy.
Well, his stance, you know, but his stance his stance, as I heard it, seemed to indicate to me that he would fund Planned Parenthood's health initiatives, but would not fund abortions at those clinics.
And I believe that's the way it is now.
I don't believe so. I believe they're intermingled, and that's why when I heard that, I thought, all of these people are falling for this, and I guess somebody's got to find out if
somebody's got something.
You guys, wait a minute, Scott, you got your sound up there? Oh, there you go. No. Where's it coming from? Oh, it was Scott. Yeah. Don't do that, Scott. I'll tell you why. Because this fucking asshole, Phil Meyer, gets on me about where I've placed the bar on the webpage.
Right. So. And it's just proving me right every single day.
Yeah. Anyway,
I don't even have to tell you about it anymore. Now you react to it and fear the fill factor and your button placement without me saying anything.
I didn't even have it on. It wasn't even making sound until Skype came up, though. It was weird.
Guilty.
Wow. Well, there we can see.
Switch to the other computer.
Scott's having a bad signal problem tonight. If I went over to this other machine, which I can't do because we're doing TV night tonight, and I use that machine, I bet every one of you would be clear as a bell. Mm. It's just the way Skype is. But anyway, I want to get back to what we were talking about because it's an interesting territory. This whole concept of, do you have to be a certain way because you're a Republican? And I don't know. You know, I mean, I know that I ran into a problem at Sirius because I had a bunch of people literally always yelling for my head in the Democratic Party and everywhere else because I didn't hew to the whole concept that, you know, Democrats had to be a certain way.
What you did the other night when you were talking to Tom, you were extremely fair, and I thought that you looked at the situation without a filter, and it's very difficult for the other side to see that. You know, they want to condemn, and you were being fair, and I thought that was, you know, well, that's why I like you.
Well, yeah. And by the way, I have no camera. My camera has a slash through it, and I can't turn it back on again. Oh boy, it's one of those nights.
You're frozen. And your hands look like you're doing a Trump.
I don't even have my camera on right now because it won't let me.
Yeah.
I wish
you want to reboot.
Huh?
You want
to? Do you all promise to call me back?
Of course.
Oh, okay. Well, wait a minute.
It'll be the fourth time tonight. I'm ready.
Okay. Hold on. I'm going to reboot. Okay. All right. So what I'm going to do here is I got to sign this thing off. Let's just quit Skype altogether. Clean it up here. Sign out. Okay. Now it's not even signing out. Oh, that's great. Quit Skype and it won't even let Skype
quit. Now you
quit.
Have no control over it.
Let me go quit here. It won't go away.
It's all locked up.
This is amazing, folks. This is just amazing. Oh man, you know, and then I try to do it. Well, let me hear. I there we go. Now let me see if I there. I got rid of everybody. Okay. Now let me reboot it and see what happens here. Then I got to put in the. Come on. There we go. All right. We're back. We're back up again, folks. Give me your best call here, and we get going again. I'm sorry. You know, this whole thing with Skype is just it's amazing. It's just the well. There is our friend Phil, and here comes Rob Alfano, and here comes Scott Boddicker, and hopefully we'll get back Tony, and hopefully we'll get back. Let's see. Rob Alfano has enabled video. Do I accept it? What is that all about?
No, I get
that all the time, too.
Yeah, yeah. Rob Alfano. Now we got to wait for Patrick, because this whole question of, you know, are you a good Republican or are you a bad Republican? I mean, if you're out stumping for the party, it doesn't mean that you have to have those values. And like I said, when I was at Sirius, I had people like. Some of these groups, what are they?
Media Matters.
Media Matters was the one that hated me, just hated me. Because they would go to Sirius and complain about me. You know, that, oh, he's not the kind of liberal you should be having on your liberal station. And, you know, it's because I was fair, that I didn't hew a certain company line where my politics were concerned. And so, you know, I thought Obama was being a terrible president, so I was saying it. And I guess, you know, I saw the emperor without his clothes on, and I'm going to get lynched.
Yeah.
Yeah. I wonder where Patrick is now.
Is he online?
Is he online? He's away, it says here.
I try moving your pot up and down. There's some slap.
Yeah, that's weird.
Really? Is there some slap back? Okay. Everything that could go wrong tonight is going wrong tonight. Including the fact that we could use a slap few more back. Callers. What?
Everybody's picture is really clear, and the slapback is gone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Alex, you look better, yeah.
Yeah, everybody's picture is very clear. That's strange. Patrick, where are you? I want to continue this conversation. Tony, where are you? I want to continue this conversation. What?
I was surprised to hear Patrick talking about the... I guess he didn't give his opinion whether or not he was pro-life or whatever.
I think he is
pro-life. I think he's more reasonable than dogmatic about that.
Yeah, you know, I mean,
here comes Patrick.
What I do for me, I don't expect other people to do for them. You know, people are free to do what they want. If they're pro-life, they're pro-life. Yeah. If I don't want to be pro-life, I don't be. But I don't force anybody else to think the way I do.
Now everybody's
you're never gonna marry a gay guy.
Everybody's incredibly clear now. Go figure, folks. Fuck Skype. Anyway, Patrick, they asked the question, and maybe you want to answer it. Are you pro or con on
pro-life?
Pro-life.
I'm pro-life when it comes to the life of a mother, or
pro-life would be anti-abortion. Are you for abortion or against abortion? Let's put it that way.
I would be for abortion with the mother's life in the balance or rape. Otherwise, I do not support it. However, I am not one of those who will protest or force somebody to feel the same way I do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in the way that I look at it, and I know I'm probably one of the few that, you know, would embrace my own faith here, but the way I look at it is it's between the woman and her God. And if that is a choice that she makes, if she's comfortable with it, who am I to judge her?
It's interesting you left out the man.
Well, I mean, I was just going to say, in the case of if it was me and it was someone in my life, I would want to be part of that choice, that decision, because that's my baby too.
Mm-hmm.
So, and
she's
the only
life in that,
that she has anything above me as a male is she has to carry it. And her body has to go through the changes and all of that. So that's where they, meaning women, have the upper hand when it comes to something like that, is maybe Rob and I would say, hey, if you don't want it, we will take it and I'll be the single father and take care of the baby on my own, but we don't have to carry it.
Right.
So where women have the upper hand. So
well, that's why I think the statement is always made that, you know, you shouldn't tell, we have no right to tell a woman what to do with her body. I know I've tried and it doesn't work. You know, I mean, I don't have the right to tell a woman she can't have an abortion. I could say to her the reasons why I might believe she shouldn't and that it would be wonderful for her to have the kid, but it's her decision because she has to live with that decision. I don't have to. That's why I hate all these anti-abortion people running around and literally trying to make other people's lives miserable, you know? Let them make that decision. It's a decision, by the way, they're going to have to live with for the rest of their lives.
On the other hand, if you're going to be fair and balanced, they believe what they're doing is they're saving lives, and that
yeah. Well, listen, we'll pull that little 1 month embryo out of the woman's snatch, we'll send it to them by mail, and they can raise it. Okay, Patrick.
I happen to know someone who got his girlfriend pregnant, and she was not supposed to be able to get pregnant. And she had medical issues that if she would have pursued the child, she could have died. And he ended up paying for her to have the abortion. And it's something that has eaten at him ever since because, you know, it was part of him as well. So, you know, it's not just the woman that has to live with the decision. If it's the male that actually cares about the woman and or the child, you have to live with that as well. Even if she makes the decision, you may have the regret. And he said this to me on a few occasions that, you know, that could have been a son or a daughter. And, mm-hmm. you know, and it was the right decision. Because otherwise the woman probably would have died, but it's still something that sits in the back of his head, and that's been,
oh, yeah.
God, 15 years ago.
Let me bring up something here. You know, when I was 18, my girlfriend got pregnant, and we thought first about getting an abortion, and I mean, I could write a movie about all the things we were going through then, because this was the 50s, and to find somebody who would give an abortion is pretty difficult, right? Mm. And we couldn't find anybody. Okay, so that was out of the question. We did things like go down to San Jose and see if we could get married, but we were both under age or something. We had to have our parents' consent or whatever.
It's Tijuana, you had to go.
So that couldn't happen. And there was one impediment after another. Finally, she told her parents, and they told her, okay, well, you know, you're going to go have the kid. And by the way, Schwarzman, get the fuck out of here. We don't want you seeing our daughter. So she was going to give the kid up for adoption. And what she did is she did give it up for adoption. And it went into that blind adoption kind of thing where there's no way I'm ever going to find the kid. It just gets lost. There's no paperwork. Gone. But
hey, Patrick,
at one point I said, if you're putting this kid up for adoption, I want to adopt the kid. You know, it's partially mine. I want it. And they wouldn't let me do it. They laughed me out of the place. You can't, you know, today I might have a case. Okay. But back then I didn't have any case at all. And she gave up the kid for adoption, and that's eaten away at me for most of my life. That's why I've never had a kid since, you know. It so profoundly affected me. I was always very careful not to get women pregnant. I didn't want to go through that again. So my question is, what are the rights of the potential father? And so I've always asked, if you want to make a, I would have no argument if you wanted to make a law that anybody who wants to get an abortion has to inform the possible father. Because there might be a misconception there. He doesn't love me. He doesn't want me. I want to get rid of this child. And if she told him, he'd go, hey, well, then let's, you know, I once had a girlfriend who we thought I got pregnant. And she said, I think I'm pregnant. She said it very sheepishly. And I said, terrific. You know, and she said, I didn't think you would be that way about it. And I said, no, let's have it, you know. And she was delighted with that. So, you know, this might have been a woman who might have thought at some point, oh, I'll go get an abortion because, you know, Bennett doesn't want to marry me or doesn't want to have a kid with me. Yeah, no, she had a miscarriage, so that didn't happen. But, you know, I just think
she really didn't, Dad.
I think there should be some rights for the potential father. Now, in some cases, nobody knows who the father is, and usually they're a Kardashian. But, you know,
Rob heard what I said. You didn't.
What? What'd you say?
I heard it.
Rob, I said she did have the kid, Dad.
Oh, I see. Yeah, sure. Like I believe that one. I've often thought that the original child that I had, you know, back in when I was 18, is probably Howard Stern.
Yeah.
No, he'd been too old. I'm the perfect age. I'm 18 years younger than you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hi, son. How are you? How are you, son?
Yeah, but he was raised Goyim.
Oh, look who doesn't call back, by the way. Tony. Wow, is he loyal.
Yeah.
You know.
Probably with Coco right now.
He sent me a picture. He was making Pete's coffee. He had a pound of Pete's coffee.
You know, I can get K-cups of Pete's coffee now.
Yeah, I that's what I've been drinking.
I love my little Keurig, man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, who told you to get it off the shelf?
Well, no, I got it off the shelf and it didn't work, so I had to go buy one. I had to go buy one, and I went over to Costco and I bought the new one for $149 with a whole bunch of like a 50 K cups and stuff in it. Then I'm walking through Costco the other day and I go see the Keurig and it's down to 99.
Well, every time you
I went to the front desk and I said it's now 99, and they looked me up because they look at it, they can find everything you buy, and they said, yeah, you bought it for $149. Here's your change.
And so I was going to say, they have a price protection.
Yeah, and it's 30 days, and this was more than 30 days, and they still gave it to me.
Oh, then I should still look at my TV.
Why, you having problems with it?
No, but if the price drops.
I have a problem with my TV set. Every now and then the sound just stops.
I use a sound bar. I don't like the speakers.
No, I have mine hooked up to a receiver.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but for some reason, the sound just cuts out every now and then. Once in a great while.
You sure? Is it the receiver?
Today it did it three times because I changed the input when it happened the first time. But no, I don't know what it is. Okay.
Because is it an HDMI connection?
No, it's an optical.
Okay. Because HDMIs are notorious for going bad.
Really?
Yeah. I had three funky receivers go bad on me. I replaced them. And finally, I got them. I had to drive it up to Silver Springs, Maryland to get it repaired. And the last time I was about to give up, I went into the guy and I said, this is the last time I'm going to do this. This is a 45-minute drive each way. I said, and it only lasts 6 months and it's doing this again. And he said, it won't happen anymore. And Ankyo realized they bought a bunch of really shitty components and they got new ones in to replace them. And it won't happen again. And it's been 2 years now.
Yes.
Yeah. Sometimes those optical connections.
I drilled a big hole and I put a fan that when it reaches 75 degrees, it automatically, the double fans go on.
Right. What are we going to say about the optical?
Sometimes they fall out or they're not in tight enough.
Mine's in tight.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. I don't know what it is. It happens when I go from one thing to another, like one input to another, and I come back and somehow the sound gets killed. It only happens occasionally, but it may be something in the programming in the set, you know. But what the hell? I've turned the set on and off and off, off and then on again, and I get the sound. So
I'm, yeah. Hey, it's been a couple of weeks now that I've cut the cord, and I couldn't be happier.
You cut the cord. He had a kid, ROKU. And he cut the cord. No, what?
I got the ROKU, and I got Sling TV, and Hulu, and Netflix.
So how much total do you figure you're paying for all that?
Are you a baseball fan?
No.
Oh, okay.
ESPN. Well, I go to baseball games, but I'm usually got my camera in my face and I'm taking pictures.
Okay, so is there anything you haven't been able to get that you want, though?
Yeah, the other night, last night was Fox. So I've got to figure out a way. Maybe if I hook up I got an extra computer or laptop laying around. Maybe I can stream it to the TV. So that, you know, when I want a Fox thing or a Channel 2, which is KTVU, I can stream live from my phone, but I can't get it on the Roku or on the Apple TV.
Well, Apple TV. Oh, I see. Because it doesn't have that thing that allows you to put it on the Apple TV. Because you.
Yeah. I'm not sure. Maybe there's a way I can wirelessly.
Well, yeah. I mean, there's.
Yes, the. What do they call that? Apple Watch or whatever.
I got an iPhone. You know.
Yeah, but there's a thing there, and it shows up on your TV. You press the button, and it.
Oh yeah. It's like there's a little TV thing.
Yeah, down below.
So
yeah.
You can send it to Apple TV.
Yeah.
That's.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I should be able to just stream it from my phone.
But it's called Apple something, and sometimes you have to turn it on in your preferences.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you should be able to do that. But barring that, I'm just thinking. Of course, you're out in Contra Costa, so to get the signal through the air would be rather difficult.
I tried that. I bought the antenna, the digital antenna, for 50 miles. You got to go on the roof, but I can't. I'm in an apartment, so the antenna gives me two stations. One is Spanish, and the other is just all movies, and neither of them are a known channel. They're both off channels.
Wow. Hmm. Well, anyway, getting back to abortion.
But they've been good.
Didn't you say you were going to do a show and tell tonight, Rob, besides the cufflinks?
Yeah.
The piss Christ.
A joke. I'm not going to pee on camera.
Huh?
I was going to piss on camera and show you my ketones. What do you call it?
The ketones.
Ketones.
Yeah.
Ketones. Yeah.
Well, wait a minute. If you'll all just kind of wait and talk to each other, I'll go in the other room, get one of my strips, pee on it, and bring it back, okay?
Yeah, but yours never turns purple.
It's not supposed to turn purple.
Yeah, if it turns purple, you're in ketosis.
No, I read that if it says negative, you have...
Maybe you got a different kind of stick.
Well, I don't know. I was reading about it here. Wait a minute. Where was it? I typed in ketones.
Remember, with Atkins, it's not ketosis, it's ketosis liposis. It's different than, it's when your body turns to burning fat rather than carbohydrates for energy. And so he calls it ketosis liposis, and it's really not ketosis.
Yeah. The test results can be negative or show small, moderate, or large quantities of ketones.
Right.
Anytime. So what do you want to have? If ketones are positive, what does it mean? There are situations you might have ketones without blood glucose and being high. Positive ketones are not a problem when blood glucose levels are in a range when you're trying to lose weight. It is a problem if blood glucose levels and left untreated. Untreated high blood glucose with positive ketones can lead to life-threatening condition called diabetic ketosis. So I think you want to be negative on the ketone side, on the strip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess the last time I had the ketone strips, they were just a color, and either purple or you weren't.
Right. Well, there's shades. It's like a...
Yeah.
Age, and it gets darker and darker and darker, and the darker it gets, the more... deeper you are into ketosis, at least that's the way.
Similar, like a litmus.
Oh, really? So I'm not into ketosis, but that doesn't mean I'm still not losing weight.
Well, that's weird, though. How could you not be in ketosis if you're on a high protein?
I thought the
when it's taking in more than 20.
I thought when it says negative that that's where you want to be.
I think it turns purple on that kind of stick that I'm familiar with if you're 20 or under.
Right.
And if you're over 20 carbs a day, then it's not purple.
Where do you get these strips at? Buy them at the
pharmacy.
But I am under 20 without thinking about it every day now.
I told you could be at 20 just by breathing. Everything's got carbs in it.
Yeah, I don't eat anything with carbs in it.
Yeah, but even if you don't, there's something in everything. You know?
Yeah, but less than one carb. I'm not eating. I've cut back my meals in the last 2 days.
Yeah.
Because I think I was eating too much.
Yeah, I'm eating too much, but I feel good. And
losing?
I'm getting thinner, but I'm not losing weight yet.
That's the same thing I'm experiencing. I've lost five pounds.
Oh, we're back now to Bennett's weight clinic here.
And it's stalled. Yeah. But yet I feel thinner. I mean, I feel clothes fit better.
Yeah, I'm losing like a half a pound a day now, but for a while I didn't lose anything, and but the clothes are thin, fitting better, yeah. and I feel better. I have a little more energy.
Yes, that's true.
Right. Well, I don't know what it's supposed to say here. I don't know what you're supposed to have.
I'll go get my jar.
Wait a minute. Now you talk to them while I pee on a strip, and then you'll go get your jar.
Okay.
Okay. Well, you run the conversation for a few moments.
Scott, can
go,
you
go
look
back,
up
go back to Patrick. Liposis. He's always interesting.
Ketosis liposis. I don't know if I can spell it, but I can try.
Joel, maybe the spell check will help you. I can't spell it either. But yeah. That's what Atkins said that you needed to be in, and it's not ketosis as a diabetic would understand it. It's ketosis liposis, which is when you start burning fat instead of sugar for energy.
Right.
Yeah.
But I never heard of the ketosis liposis part. I've only heard of it as ketosis.
I read it in the New Atkins Diet Revolution.
His book. Haven't read anything since the original Atkins book, the yellow paperback.
That's the one I read.
Oh. Maybe I missed that part, or maybe I forgot it.
Yeah.
25 years since I read that book.
And originally I was on there was a blog where you could ask questions and so forth of other people on Atkins. And, I think that I might have also picked up some stuff from that, but that was 20 years ago.
I mean, I've been doing, like, it's really weird. You're on a diet and you know, I'll take 2 pounds of chicken wings and throw them in the deep fryer and get some Frank's hot sauce and 2/3 of a stick of butter and mix it all in and throw the wings in there and use blue cheese dressing, and that's dinner.
Yeah, and you can have lobster, you can have shrimp. You even get tired of those things.
Yeah. Well, no, I swear to you, I don't do more than I would say 10 carbohydrates a day.
I don't see how you can stay.
I do it. But anyway, in case people don't know, this is what they're talking about.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, you're in ketosis.
I'm in ketosis?
Yeah.
The blue? No, the purple.
The blue is glucose.
Oh, okay.
My strips don't have glucose.
Yeah.
Just the one pad.
But the
discount strips.
I'm kind of, I can't tell where I am. I'm lighter than I should be for that, but you know, on the ketones, I guess I'm moderate on ketones.
Well, that's good. That's fine.
Does that look about what it does for you?
Same product? Maybe a little darker than that. The last time I checked it.
Do you have something that you hold it up to that tells you measures it?
Right, yeah, there's a chart there.
Oh, okay.
That's what mine looks like.
Only yeah, but have see the purple. The purple on the end.
Oh, wait a minute. So this way. This way. Which way is it? Here. This is the way it should be. There we
go. Yeah.
Yeah.
So yours is looking like it's neutral almost. And
yeah.
Neutral?
Yeah, wouldn't you say?
Which color do you match?
Well, I can't tell here exactly. I think I match small. No?
Was it the 10? Or?
No. I can't. There's really nothing that I match here.
In between two?
No.
Are you in between two colors?
I think maybe I'm between moderate and small.
So was Trump.
Yeah. I don't know. All I know is I'm losing weight, okay? I'm losing weight. So, you know. You want to go get your strip? Go get your strip.
Go pee.
Rob's going to go pee in a cup now for
it. That one, Phil.
And look at what Patrick has put up. P.I. Yeah, must. Back I will be. But get a ketone strip, Patrick.
It takes him a while.
No, it doesn't.
Doesn't he have to grab and stab?
He grabs and stabs, but he's very good at it. Oh. You know. But these strips are expensive, by the way.
Yeah.
100 of these damn things, $40.
Oh, I'm not buying them.
I get those things free. I have a test kit to test the pH of floors to see if they're alkaline or you know, then there's a presence of moisture in concrete slabs.
And they work
so
for this?
I get free ones.
Huh? Yeah, but I mean, this strip is like it's a 50-cent strip right there, maybe as 45.
You piss on it.
Huh? And then you pee on it. You know what I mean? But
50 cents a piece, and you got 100 of them? So you paid $50 for
No, I paid for it 40, so it's like 40 cents a piece.
Wow.
Then you come in there, so I don't know. I never, you know, I don't know if I'm in ketosis or not. It doesn't matter. I'm losing weight.
Do you have to use one every day, or are you supposed to use it every day or once a week?
I use it for grins every now and then to see how I'm doing. But I have no idea because it doesn't match any of the colors.
Scott, did you find that ketosis liposis?
I found ketosis, and I found a paleo diet that Lance was on, but I'm struggling to find ketosis liposis or whatever you're saying. So,
Lance sent me some very interesting information, you know, about testing your sugar and diabetes. He really knows his stuff.
Yeah, but I test negative here for glucose, so yeah.
Well, that's good.
No, that's fine. You know, hey, listen, I'm losing weight, and that's all that matters.
Yeah.
And
Once you get down to your ideal weight, are you going to continue?
Well, I want to get back to my original weight, which is 7 pounds 6 ounces.
Yeah. Oh, that's purple.
That's purple.
He's in ketosis.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on a second. Let me look at that.
Yours may have changed.
Bring it back. Just a smidge. Your autofocus isn't working on it.
What happened to mine? I lost mine.
Okay. Hey, I found something out about rating.
God, there's a ketosis strip running around here.
Let
me see here. No, I didn't throw it in the
garbage. Let the cat get it.
So Rob is really doing good.
Let's see, Rob. Let me see what this looks like.
Yeah, this is deep in ketosis.
That's the deal. March.
Well, mine was kind of getting into that. Wait a minute. What happened to my ketosis
strip?
Yeah,
you took some paint and sprayed it.
Wait a minute. No, it's not in the garbage here.
Your strip must be cheaper because it only had the one test strip.
Yeah, I feel ripped off. I didn't get this. It's called smackfat.com.
Yeah. And how much did it cost you? How much did it cost you?
These were $9.
Really? I paid $40.
Did you get it on Amazon? $40.
Yeah. Let me see.
I bought them on Amazon. That's right.
How many strips in a thing?
How many strips in this thing? 100 ketone strips.
Yeah.
$9.
Hmm. Well, so it's actually, mine was kind of dark. Where is it?
After 30 seconds or a minute, it changes.
Oh, here it is. Now, wait a minute. Let's compare this. Hold yours up. Hold yours up.
You paid a lot of money for your strips.
Rob. Now, look, there's mine.
Looks like a pool strip.
Do they look pretty much alike, don't they?
No, yours looks more reddish.
Orange.
More reddish, but almost orange-ish. As dark as his, right?
No, his is purple, yours is orange, but it's getting there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, what's it supposed to mean is what I don't get.
If it's purple, you're in ketosis.
But does that mean I'm not losing weight if I'm not in ketosis?
No, doesn't mean you're not losing weight. It just means you're not in ketosis. No. So when you're in ketosis, you lose the maximum amount of weight.
Yeah. Yeah, we're still talking about this since you went to take a pee, Patrick. That is terrible. When we talked about peeing, that probably made you want to pee, right?
No, I have to time it.
What do you mean you have to time it?
I have to take into consideration how much liquid I've taken in and timing and how much I've taken in through the day.
Yeah.
Because otherwise I run the risk of pissing myself.
Oh.
So you can't feel when your bladder is full or when you have to go. So you run it on a on a schedule.
Yeah,
but Patrick, you were supposed to time it that it didn't happen for another 27 minutes.
Well, actually, that's what I wanted. That's what I wanted to do, but I drank damn near all of my coffee, and that's 15 ounces.
Yeah,
I thought, yeah, what's going to happen is once I hit the end of the hour, I'm going to need to run to the bathroom, and I can't run. So, you know.
Yeah, I get it.
So, yeah. All right. So, you know, good, good. So I, anyway, getting back to abortion, it's amazing how we go back and forth on stuff here.
Well, it's all weight loss.
I mean,
the rabbit died.
What should be the rights of the potential father? That's what the question is here, I guess.
Well, the Democrats say you have no right.
Well, you know, I think that the potential father should be able to have a conversation with the woman before she goes ahead and does whatever she wants to do. It's ultimately her choice.
Then if it's ultimately her choice, why bother? Why bother legislating something like he should have the right? If I could say, I want it, and she's going to say, my right,
you're talking about a guy who's had a kid stolen from him. You know,
yeah,
and so that that emotion plays into my feelings about this.
I mean, let's assume that you get a woman pregnant, and you're going to have that discussion. You would think.
Well, you know, I didn't get to have that discussion after a certain point. You know, and then it was just we're giving up the kid. You can't do anything about it. You know, Patrick.
It's kind of the same deal for me. Is even though my ex's kids weren't mine, that whole situation has fucked with my head so bad that I can't see myself getting into another relationship with younger kids. They would have to be adult children because I wouldn't be able to deal with it emotionally if we broke up.
Right.
And it's the same as I would. And that's a nice thing about hitting 40 years old now, is the clock is just about run out for most women, that I wouldn't have to worry about getting somebody pregnant and dealing with that, because I don't know if I would be able to come back from something like that, where getting somebody pregnant and then finding out she had an abortion, and, you know, I would want that child. So I'm kind of in the same boat as you, Alex, that way, that, you know, I've had it taken away from me, and I haven't seen these kids in almost 4 years now.
Yeah.
And there isn't a day that goes by that it doesn't bother me. And, you know, I think about them constantly.
Yeah.
So, you know, I think there needs to be a conversation, but ultimately, you know, she's going to do what she's going to do. And it, like I said earlier, she's the one carrying it. So no matter what you or I or any guy would say that would want it, if you're not carrying it, she can pretty much say, go fuck off.
Well, no, I mean, she ultimately has to make the choice. Because she is the one that ultimately is going to have to live, you know, to begin with, she's going to have to go through giving birth to the child. You know, it'd be nice if as guys, we could just say, well, if you don't want to have it, just give it to me and I'll bear it. But you can't do that. She has to go through the birth. She has to
sit
go through
it.
All of that. What?
You could sit on
you
it.
You could sit on it. Yeah. Yeah. But I mean, she's going to have to live with the decision too, far more than you are, because if you're having that kid cut out of you, that's going to affect a woman far more than it's going to affect the man. It's going to affect the man if he's any kind of a decent human being. But the fact of the matter is, she has to lie there on that gurney and have it done. All right? And I don't know any woman that I've known that had an abortion that didn't feel bad about it. This idea that the Republicans have, that people are just willy-nilly happy to walk into Planned Parenthood and get their uterus scraped, is something they don't mind. There isn't a woman I know who hasn't had second thoughts afterwards, or for many months afterwards, and maybe years. Yeah. You know, it still kind of haunted them.
I've had two women in my life who were special to me, who I went out with for long periods of time. And both of them, these two, after about 6 months of being with them, one night you go pick them up or whatever, and there was hysterical crying. What's wrong? What's wrong? I have to tell you something. 5 years ago, I had an abortion.
5 years ago?
Yeah, years ago. That's how it affects them. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, two women told me that, you know, that you get like, holy shit, what's wrong? You know, did somebody die? No, you're going to hate me. You're going to judge me. I had an abortion. And they go, look, I'm not going to judge you. That's between you and your maker, whatever.
Exactly.
You know, I don't have anything to do with it. I don't going to judge you on that.
But still, I it would be nice if the man, I mean, because again, I have that prejudice because of what I went through. If the man were informed that, hey, you know, she's about to either give up your child for adoption, as was in my case, or she's going to go out and have an abortion, that somehow you're able to have some kind of a discussion before that's done, because you might find out that things aren't the way you think they are.
Right. You know? I think that's worse, knowing that your child is out. Well, maybe not, but I would think that's worse, knowing that there's a kid running around here that's your, you know, you didn't give it up.
I kept waiting for the knock on the door. You know, and when I was in San Francisco, I told the story on the air because I've always been very open about my life. And people said to me, well, haven't you tried to find the child? And I said, well, no, not really. And then I thought about it and, you know, whatever. And finally, I had some detectives get a hold of me who said, we'll do it pro bono, just to go do it and see if we can find your kid. And I thought long and hard about it and then decided no. And the reason I decided no was, and I said this on the air, I said, I've decided not to go looking for my kid. Because I think if the kid wants to find out who his father is, I think he should come find me. For me to go find him, I would not want to jump into this kid's life. Him thinking maybe he doesn't even know that he was adopted. Right. You know, I don't know what the situation is.
Yeah, and they
and I know I know it was a boy, but I could give you the long story on how I know it's a boy. But if he feels he wants to find me, fine. Here I am. Come find me. But
you had the offer of two detectives to find them. He, you know, that's expensive. He might not have those resources if he wanted.
I think he could go find out who his father was a lot easier than I could find out where he was, because the trail wasn't muddied both ways. You know what I'm saying, Patrick?
Yeah, I agree with you, Alex. That. If this kid already had a life established, and or whether or not they knew they were adopted or not, if the life is already established, it's up to them to go find the parent. And I know somebody in my own life who was adopted, mm-hmm. did not know they were adopted until they were like 16 or so, when they could comprehend it. Had no interest in finding out who their adoptive parents were until they ran into a health issue. And then it was a matter of going back into the records mm-hmm. to find that mother or father, because there were health issues that were going on, and found out that there was a history of whatever it was in the family. And then they ended up getting to know one another. They were never,
yeah,
and still aren't close per se, but they're on a very cordial, you know, like extended family sort of deal.
Yeah.
But I agree. I think it's up to the kid to pursue that rather than the adult, you know, jamming themselves into a life that's already been made.
So I never did. You know, and
made the right choice.
Yeah. Now many years. This is a strange story. Her name was Sandy. I'll just say that first name. I'm on the radio in San Francisco doing my shows, and I get, was it a call or was it a letter? I think it was a letter. Hi, this is Sandy. Do you remember me?
Oh boy.
And then she starts naming people that I knew with the Sandy that had my kid. And that she was naming him. And so I, Phil, did you hang out with Phil? And have you seen Phil? And have you seen so-and-so? And I'm going, it's that Sandy. And so I said, can I call you? And she said, yeah, sure. And I call her. And I don't want to just immediately say, hey, what happened to the kid, right? But I'm kind of leading the subject in every direction I can towards that goal. And I said, I just want you to know that you had a very profound effect on my life. And she said, I can't imagine why. And I can't. And she never, ever brought up the kid.
And you didn't? She
and
was dating
I didn't,
six
I didn't,
guys,
I didn't want
six
to,
other guys.
Listen,
and
I
just took Thursday.
I didn't want to impose myself upon her that way, because if it's something she either blocked out of her mind, again, it's like the kid, you know, if it's something she blocked out of her mind or didn't want to remember or didn't want to talk about, I wanted her to bring it up, but I was giving her every opportunity to do it. I was leading her into question areas and so on. And it was undoubtedly that Sandy, right? And then she starts, with a couple more calls, she starts complaining. She says, I got this son. He's a problem. So I got two kids. One of the kids is great. And the younger one, the older one, rather, he's neurotic. And he's and she sent me a picture of the kid, I think. And he was bald, you know. And I'm going, he's neurotic. He's bald, you know. Could it have been that she said she gave the kid up for adoption and didn't at all? You know,
yeah. And if the parent told you to kiss off.
Yeah.
They might have told you that just so you'd get away from her and leave her alone.
Yeah. So in any event, then she would never admit to it. And finally, I got sick of talking to her about it and just stopped talking to her, you know. But she had always was living a terrible life. And then she sent me a picture of herself. Now, here's the thing I don't get. She sent me a picture of herself, and it didn't look anything like the woman I had gone out with when I was younger. Okay. She had gained a lot of weight. Yeah. And, you know, when people gain a lot of weight, you can't tell whether it was. Sometimes you'll see.
You think she was scamming you? Or?
No, because she couldn't have known all these facts if she was scamming me, you know? She was naming the names of people we hung out with, places we would go, things like that. No person who was trying to scam me would be able to do it that well. They'd be doing a lot of research, and then at the end of the rainbow, they'd be holding me up for some money, and she wasn't. Yeah. You know? So.
Was the kid black?
No.
I got something funny, but it's a little offensive.
What is it, Pat?
It's something Patrick. About Obama and Trump.
Anthony. Yes, Anthony.
If Trump replaces Obama in the White House, does that mean orange is the new black?
Oh, it's good. It's
bravo.
Good.
Did you make that up?
No. Oh, I sent somebody send it to me, and I'm pissing my fans holding this in.
Oh, use a ketone stick.
Oh, Lord, I can tell it like this. It's a good TV
show. Is orange the new black? Yeah, yeah. I loved the Trump, the Drudge thing last night, Cuban sandwich.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't come better than that. No. So listen, we lost Ben Carson.
Yeah.
Did he quit?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, he said he spent more money on advisors than he did on advertising. So maybe that's why he didn't do so well.
The thing I think you don't need most of all are advisors. I mean, do you actually think Trump's got advisors?
Yeah, I do.
Trump listens to anybody.
I think Trump listens to
Trump
people
may have
and then makes
people,
his own decision.
Yeah, yes. But, you know, Rubio doesn't make his own decisions. He listens to whatever his advisors say to do, you know.
But
And look at what advisors get you. You know?
Well, look at Carson. Carson came up with that, I hit somebody over the head with a hammer thing. Do you think that was some advisor telling him to make yourself look tougher so you have some street credit?
Could have been.
That didn't go over very well.
Could have been. I mean, he says he had consultants. You know, I think if Trump has consultants, it's people he trusts that he's known for years in politics who are just giving him some ideas. But I think he's doing whatever he feels like doing. I mean, you don't see him. He's not reading a teleprompter up there.
No, he talks off the well.
Well, you know what he does? I'll tell you what he does. And it's a brilliant tactic. He gets up there and gives a speech like he's just talking to you. Right. You know, hey, and this happened to me, and that happened to me, and oh, look at my belt, and da, 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 you know, and he draws people into him dealing with them personally, and then telling them about his life and you know the television business and things like that. They love that. You know, it's an amazing thing. It just amazes me the whole way that thing has set itself up. But it's been, I don't think he ever went into it thinking he would get this far.
You kind of predicted it, though, remember?
It's kind of like coming true. All I said was, when people said, it'll never happen.
And I was laughing when
I went, don't count on it, you know? You're going to be, you may be surprised.
In the beginning,
I
didn't support him in the beginning. I liked Christie and Huckabee better than I liked Trump. And then as time went by,
Come you always go for the assholes? Jeez almighty.
First I was for
who did you say you were for first?
Yeah, who are you for
first? I liked Christie.
Christie. And then you liked Huckabee. You heart Huckabee.
I liked Huckabee last election too. Yeah, you know, in the last time he ran.
You're Jewish. He's a Christian fundamentalist. Yeah, what are you even thinking about him Bibles. For?
He believes in baby Jesus.
Yeah, well, you know, Jesus was Jewish too.
You know what I was going to tell you, Alex, with Romney? Yeah. Let me ask you this, what you think of this. Remember how he's railing against, like, Trump, how he's saying, like, he can't be the conservative? Isn't he basically insulting the people voting for Trump?
Nah.
It's kind of like, you know, we know better than they do.
Tony, he said tonight that he feels that he needs to say something, and he should have said something earlier.
Why should he say anything? I don't get it.
He's not fooling us. He's positioning himself to be drafted.
Yeah.
You know, he's just hoping and praying that phone is going to ring.
Rice Priebus says that there will not be a brokered convention.
Rubio's got his fingers and everything crossed that it's going to be broken.
He must be squeaky clean Trump, because believe me, by now they would have found whatever it was to get him out of there.
You know, I was thinking that myself, that he has not, you know, no, in other words, there's no stuff about, oh, you know, he cheated on his wife or whatever.
He did.
Well, don't know that.
Multiple people.
No, I mean, you know, but he's kind of Teflon proof that way, because if they said he had an affair, blah, 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 you go, oh, so. You know, he picked up a hooker in Washington. So, yes, it's Patrick. Donald Trump. Yeah, he's Donald Trump. But you don't hear about him with hookers, you know.
No.
Hell, with that kind of money, I'd populate my home with them. you
hot,
know,
cold Patrick, running
room. Hot and cold running whores, you know. Yes, Patrick.
Let's assume that he gets the Republican nomination, mm-hmm. and him versus Hillary.
Yeah.
Really think that the Democrats do not have an arsenal to unleash on Trump, that they're holding back because they are hoping that he is the one that she goes again. And I know I heard you say earlier that there's no way that she can beat him, and I don't disagree with that, but I think there is dirt that's being held back and being held back for strategic reasons.
Patrick, they don't need to hold dirt back. They can make stuff up. You know, Hitler said that if you repeat something often enough,
big lie.
It becomes the truth.
Yeah. Right, but now's not the time to do it, Phil, for the Democrat. Because
no, they'll do it. They'll do it during the main election. Why should they jump their load now?
So, I mean, that's my point, and you're right. They can make stuff up, but the idea that they would have found already, I think the Democrats are holding close to the vest and are going to wait.
But the Democrats,
they could easier get something on him business wise, okay, than they could get on him politically. I mean, what can we call it? Morally.
Yeah,
I think that any moral thing. I often said, you know, I did that, and they said, well, you know, what if the public finds out? And I said, they'll fully expect that out of me. I said, so you can't, you, I made myself Teflon proof by just making everybody go, oh, he went out with a hooker last night? That's Alex, you know, or whatever. Though I never went out with hookers, oddly enough. But I built a safety valve in my career by being out there. Okay, so anything they could say about Donald Trump morally, everybody would just go, oh, Donald, glad you got laid. Now, business-wise, if they could find him in some stinky, rotten deal and question it, that might be his Achilles heel.
I think the Republicans, if they haven't found it, the Democrats aren't going to find it. The Democrats will make it up, but and that's what they did to Romney. You know, they said with Bain Capital, he bought companies, he laid people off, he did all of this stuff.
He did.
And he made that up.
He did do it.
I understand, but they made it worse than it really was. He didn't necessarily lay people off. There were certain companies they bought, and they were companies that had to be shut down.
Took their pension from them.
I don't know about that.
Look yes.
What do you mean you don't know about that? Then you should find out more about the candidate you're voting for. Then you should find out more about the candidate you're voting for, because that was almost a known fact.
Yeah, I think there was more to the story than just he laid people off and stole their pensions. Next they'll say he hit the old lady over the head and took her purse.
But Bain Capital was famous for grabbing companies and gutting them for the individual. No, Bain Capital was famous for buying up companies and then gutting them up and selling them for their individual parts.
You know that Bain Capital is one of the number one companies to work for in the United States?
Well, to work for, but not to work against. You lost me, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Here it comes.
I'm ready to lose me.
Huh?
Nothing.
What? Go ahead, Scott. You got something to say. Come on.
No.
Come on, Scott. Come on, Scott.
Take another 5 minutes.
Come on. I need 5 minutes. Come on, Scott.
I'm good.
You're letting us down. We know
you're not drinking enough.
No. You know, if you can find a sleazeball in politics, Phil will vote for them. He just he's attracted to sleazeballs. I mean, can you imagine?
Perot's a stand-up guy. His people were in jeopardy, and he went in and hired a guy, and he got his people out of Iran when things hit the went to shit.
Nothing against Perot. He's not Republican.
Well, yeah, but I voted for
him. There you go.
They made fun of Perot, but he was kind of right about it. Remember the sucking of the job?
Even Alex said that his business manager, which he has a lot of respect for, also voted for him.
And I still give him a bad time about it.
I think I voted for Perot. I'm not sure, but I think I did.
What was the name of his party?
The Reform Party.
Reform Party, yeah. Okay. What a misguided thing that turned out to be, though, because he bailed on you. I mean, I would be mad at him for doing
that. The second time, not the first time.
What do you mean, not the first time?
First time he bailed.
No, he bailed.
Just the second time.
On the first run for the White House, he bailed.
Nope.
Right.
Nope.
What do you mean, nope?
No. In 92, he did. In 96, he did.
Did he do it twice?
He only ran once.
He ran twice. He ran once when he was on the ticket, and the second time he bailed.
No, it was during the same.
He got a lot of votes the first time. He even
20%. He got 20%.
A couple of counties or something. I don't know what, but yeah, he got like 19 million votes the first time. But second time he dropped out. He was,
I only remember him running once.
Yeah, me too.
How about you, Rob? Do you remember?
I'm looking it up right now, quite frankly, because I don't remember. It says here he ran in 92, initial campaign. He appeared on February 20, Larry King show, and that's when he announced it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, because he's big news down here, obviously, in Dallas area, so it was...
Time he was running, was he running as a Reform candidate or a Republican?
I'm pretty sure he's Reform then.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to look it up, but I think that if he ran a second time, that wasn't the time he bailed out. He was just trying to make a comeback, and it didn't work. Because everybody felt they had gotten stung by him the first time. Except for Phil, of course.
I voted for him the first time.
And when Hitler comes back, you're going to enjoy voting for him, too. You know,
And even Trump, when he was like in 2000, he was actually in the Reform Party, too. He was going to run in 2000 because Ross had set this thing up for a couple, you know, eight years. And
yeah,
like Hitler's motto when he comes back is going to be not so bad once you get to know him.
Is it possible that he in 92, he started out running and then he withdrew. And then in October of that year, he came back.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Right. That was it. But he abandoned his people, you know, which is kind of amazing. Okay. Hey, listen, we only had five people on tonight. I don't know what happened to the rest of you people out there.
So there was six. That's, you know.
Yeah, it's a nice night. I mean, we had some good discussion here. I always love to have Patrick about. Whenever I can get him, because he's terrific, and Scott, he's terrific, and Anthony, I love you, Anthony, and Rob is terrific, and Phil.
poor Phil.
Poor Phil. Poor Phil. Anyway,
I got thanks for Reagan fan.
Hey, thanks to all of you. I really appreciate it.
Good night.
Good night. Okay. And let me close off the Skype lines here and say to the rest of you, thank you for joining us on the TV side. And I'm going to go over there to turn things off, and I'll see you back here in a second. In the meantime, if you see her, tell her I love her, okay? Okay, there we go. Okay, so I just wanted to come back here and say good night to all of you, and thank you for joining us for the TV version of The Ramble. Not a lot of people tonight, but it was a fun night tonight, and plus you got to see our use of the strips, okay? All right. Anyway, have a good night, everybody, and I'm signing off. See you later. Let me see. How do I turn this fucking thing off? Oh, there we go.